Hello, my name is Bastiaan van Loenen. I am an associate professor at Delft University of Technology. My research is focused on stimulating the reuse of public sector geoinformation. In this lecture, I will explain key legal challenges around open government data from a user perspective. This is important because publication and sharing of government data requires knowledge about the legal aspects of sharing government information. After this video, you should be acquainted with user perspective of government data, a general overview of the relevant legal issues and legal challenges evolving around open government data. We will start with the user perspective of government data. If we talk about the use of data, three main issues need to be addressed. First, the data needs to be known and findable. Second, the data should be available both from a legal and financial standpoint. And third, the data should satisfy the technical needs of the user. In each circle, the law may have a role to play. In the first circle, by requiring the publication of the data on the internet. In the middle circle, by maximizing the price of the data, setting the use restrictions and requiring access through certain services. And finally, in the innermost circle, by requiring metadata documentation, harmonized data specifications and the publication in certain formats. The law, therefore, has a major role to play in open government data. In her dissertation, Kathleen Janssen provided a nice overview of the legal components that matter. In the center of this figure are the laws promoting access to and use of government data. On the left side of the figure, the data user is depicted, while the data provider is on the right side. The top and bottom show the legal issues that may limit the access and use of the data. Please note that the interpretation and implementation of the legal components vary among countries. For example, privacy law in the US is very different from privacy law in the European Union. An example of a law promoting access to government information is the EU directive on the reuse of public sector information. This law obliges European member states to make all documents reusable unless access is restricted or excluded under national rules. Another example is the INSPIRE directive concerning the establishment of an infrastructure for spatial information in the European community. This EU directive promotes public data use by requiring 24/7 access through predefined services, standardized metadata documentation and harmonized data specifications. Although the spirit of these existing laws embraces the open data philosophy, true open data laws incorporating the full user perspective are still non-existing. One may wonder, do we need such a law? And if so, what should it look like? Now that we discussed the legal framework for government information sharing, let's have a look at some legal challenges. A first legal challenge is that besides promoting access to government data, the law may limit access to this data. Data protection, privacy and intellectual property rights are well-known examples of the mechanisms that potentially may limit data use. One big challenge for government information and data sharing is the extending scope of the definition of personal data. In the following example, I will explain this legal challenge. Here we see individual datasets, which have no direct connection to individuals. These datasets are all provided as open data. However, with more and more open datasets and advanced data mining technologies in the hands of an increasing number of people, all these anonymous datasets may together provide a pretty good picture of an individual. And therefore, each single dataset contributing to the picture may be regarded as personal data. And personal data is subject to personal data legislation restricting its use. Personal data can never be open data. One may wonder how many datasets should be considered personal data. Will there be any open data left? And there are more legal challenges. For example, there are many open licenses available, but these different open licenses are not identical. How do we ensure that different licenses can be combined in a smooth manner? How about liability arising out of unfair competition with open government data, or errors in the data, or using third-party data? And How can the law best facilitate or enforce open government data? So we touched upon the important role of law in governmental data sharing. The law is important in arriving at open data objectives and has a major role in promoting access and reuse of public sector information. However, on the other side, the law on data protection also challenges the open data philosophy and may reduce the number of open data sets significantly. If you want to know more about the legal challenges, you can have a look at the sources provided here. Enjoy the course and thank you for your attention.